So credit rating is widely recognized to be among the most critical methods for assessment of creditworthiness. So it is applicable to individual, corporate, country, even states. So there are agencies, they will evaluate the individuals, companies, state, countries. After evaluation, they will give some appropriate credit scores. So world after 2008 witnessed emergence of strict financial regulations. So what is the relevance of this 2008? The credit rating is very strict and stringent.
2008 global financial crisis exactly. International banking crisis അവിടെ ലേമൻ ബ്രദേഴ്സ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു ബാങ്കിന്റെ അവർക്ക് അവിടെ ഒരു റിയൽ എസ്റ്റേറ്റ് ഒരു ബബിൾ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അപ്പം ഈ മോർഗേജ് മോർഗേജ് ബാക്ക്ഡ് സെക്യൂരിറ്റീസ് എല്ലാം കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ നമ്മൾ കടം പിടിച്ചിരിക്കുന്ന മോർഗേജ് ബാക്ക് സെക്യൂരിറ്റീസിന്റെ ഒക്കെ വാല്യൂസ് ഭയങ്കരമായിട്ട് ഡൗൺ ആയപ്പോ ഉണ്ടായ ഒരു ക്രൈസിസ്.
Yes, exactly. 2008, the subprime crisis, and the crisis was emerged due to the subprime lending, the concept called subprime lending. Subprime lending, you may familiar that loans were given to parties without proper backed securities. The loans were default committed by the parties, and after that, the loans were given by the bank to the parties that loans were insured and through an instrument which was called as credit default swap. And this credit default swap, after a repayment default made by the individual, that repayment was insured through another financial institution. That was an insurance company. That insurance company compensate the bank for default made by the borrower. Finally, the insurance companies were bankrupt and they were closed with their operation because they had to repay the entire loans default by the individual borrowers. So that was a chain, and that crisis was termed as a prime lending, and the global economy was a great trouble that time. And after that, we can see a lot of improvisation on the credit rating companies' evaluation metrics. So they have included some more components for credit rating purpose. So we can look on the improvisation made by the credit raters or credit rating companies after the global economic crisis that was happening in 2008. So the factors influencing credit rating: management of credit in terms of its availability, associated risk, aligned returns, and payment default of customers availing credit facilities are one of the key activities of lending organization. So credit related activities such as credit allocation, credit distribution, credit procurement, credit recovery, etc., are undertaken by banks, financial institutions, and non-banking financial companies to determine credit worthiness of their clients. So you can see that every bank has a separate mechanism for credit allocation and the credit distribution and credit procurement and credit recovery. There are four departments in every banks, every financial institution. They are providing loans or they are providing lending. And these variables are very important while determining the credit worthiness of their clients. Every lending organization wants to ensure a foolproof management of risk associated with credit rendered. Every lending organization wants to ensure a foolproof management of risk. So evidence mechanism is to be strong. Recently, you have heard that Vijay Mallya's securities, the banks have decided to sell it off the Vijay Mallya securities. And they have approached the court before doing this activity. Okay. So credit rating agencies are independent third parties determining credit rates of the entity based on financial performance. So credit rating agencies are independent third parties. They are very independent third parties. Their role is to determine the credit rates of entity based on the financial performance. Credit rating agencies contribute significantly to the debt processing and guide lenders on the credit worthiness of the clients. So lenders often use information provided by credit rating agencies to decide upon the cost of debt in the form of either interest rate to be applied on debt or repayment term. So the credit rating agencies will always give information to the lenders, and this information is vital for the lenders to even to determine the loan interest rate or credit card interest rate. So last class I have explained that in the US there was a system, and they will the banks will give loans to the people who do not have even property or a job, etc., but their interest rate was high. So the credit risk is a factor, or the rating score was a factor behind the determination of the interest rate to be applied on debt or a bond, or a determination of repayment terms. It's all depend on the score given by the credit rating agencies. For instance, a borrower with lower credit score is burdened with higher interest rate, whereas a borrower having a good credit rating were encouraged to borrow more at lower interest rate. So this is interesting. I think some of the banks in India, private sector banks in India, also following this criteria. In developed countries, banks already experienced this criteria to determine the interest rates. This is the determination of interest rate in accordance with the risk of the risk factor of the borrower. There are some indicators acquired great importance in determination of credit worthiness, suggested to consider the discriminatory power of financial and non-financial indicators to determine credit rates. So there are many indicators which are prominent nowadays to determine the credit worthiness. So we can look on these indicators. The new indicators emerged. I already pointed out that there were some new indicators emerged after the crisis. The crisis is a learning experience to the credit raters, and they have changed the criteria. They have changed their indicators while determining the credit rating of the clients. Along with financial factors, non-financial factors should be also be considered important determinant of credit worthiness. So apart from the financial factors, non-financial factors should also be considered. So in earlier, it was only quantitative factors like credit history, what much default, or something like that. But now the qualitative aspects are also considered. So we are familiar with the quantitative and qualitative research. And quantitative research means something which is measurable. But the qualitative research, now it is an emerging area, like we can do research with the help of Twitter data, Facebook, LinkedIn. Even we can do research with the help of pictures, images, videos, panel discussions, etc. Even we can do discussion and research with the help of a speech of a person. Five or six talk given by a person, we can get a conclude based on that six talk given by a particular person. This is qualitative. So qualitative aspects are also considered by the banks or credit rating agencies while determining the credit worthiness of a person or a company. That is non-financial factors. So this is very important. Sustainability is important. Sustainability is an influencing parameter of credit worthiness. According to QBAS-DIAS Scenario 2018, higher credit rates ensure better sustainable performance. So sustainability means over a period of time, the company's performance. Recently, you have read a news that I was wondered that some of the companies in the BSE, listed in the BSE, they haven't have an office, and the people who communicated to the office or numbers, there was not responding that, and even BSE now they cannot identify the companies. But these companies are listed in the Bombay Stock Exchange. The companies are termed as a vanishing companies, and you will be wondering because many of the people have holding the shares of these companies. So sustainability is important. Sustainability means the performance of the company over a period of time that shows the sustainability of the company. How far the company sustain in the competitive environment. So this is a huge, this is a high important factor while determining the credit worthiness of the company. However, they remark that the correlation between credit rates and sustainability was derived by studying traditional sustainability measures and not the novel quantitative sustainability performance measures. So there was some criteria used by the credit raters to capture the effect of sustainability. Sustainability is a main variable, and this variables are, this particular variable is divided into different categories. And this category-wise information are collected from the clients and determine the total sustainability index of that particular company. So the study suggests that the entity having good credit rating can sustain long. So that is a positive relationship. And there were studies on sustainability and credit rating. So if the company's credit rating is more, that means the company's sustainability is more. The company will be like, as you learn in the basic classes of plus two or a degree, that is a going concern concept. The company is going like it's a never-ending process. So the information given to credit rating agencies that is to be taken care of. Some of the companies, are giving biased information to the credit rating agencies to get more rating. So the credit rating agencies are to be vigilant while taking care of the information given by the clients to the credit rating companies. So information provided to the credit rating agencies by clients plays important role in determining credit scores. If manipulated information is provided to credit rating agencies, credit rates so determined will not reflect the real credit worthiness of clients. So it's very important. So therefore, transparency in the credit rating is important factor for credit rating agencies to earn trust of clients, investors, and regulations. So there is a problem, there is a debatable issue here, how the credit rating agencies will consider the information given by the companies for rating. So to raise the confidence of these users, credit rating agencies must focus on the development of an effective mechanism for identifying potential factors responsible for arising conflicts of interest. So there should be a proper mechanism or a counter check, cross check criteria applicable to the information given by the clients, information given by the companies for rating. So nowadays, good credit rating companies have their own mechanism to check the information given by the clients for rating. This is a very pertinent adoption of international financial reporting standards. So this adoption of international financial reporting standards is beneficial for upgrading credit rating. If the corporate have already adopted these IFRS, that means the credit rating score would be improved. If the corporate is not adopted these IFRS, that means the credit rating will be reduced. So IFRS is the standard international code of accounting that enable the credit rating score of companies. It's a uniform accounting system. That means a company going for the international scenario, this IFRS is important so that the comparison between the companies across the globe is possible. So a company going towards IFRS is very important to get the credit rating score. Okay. Then economic factors are crucial. Credit rating of any entity should be determined on the basis of economic factors. The turnover in real assets have a considerable impact. It means economic performance of the company is very important. The profitability position of the company, the turnover as compared to the real asset, and the cost of debt, interest rate with creditworthiness, credit rates assigned to client. These are very important factors while determining the credit. That is, the factors are termed as economic factors. Now there are credit rating models emerged. You know, after 2008, there are credit rating models emerged. These models are using the methodologies you have already studied, the regression, logic, probit models, etc. So last 3 or 4 months back, we had a webinar and a professor talked about these logit probit models, and these logit probit models are used for the credit rating purpose or evaluation of credit rating. So these methodologies, including statistical analysis such as discriminant analysis, logistics regression, and decision tree, were common techniques to develop these models. So these are quantitative as well as qualitative models. These models are very useful for the purpose of determination of credit score of a company, whether the company repay back or whether the company is not able to repay back will be assessed with the help of some past data. Okay, so these methodologies being termed as credit rating models. These models, Emma, these models means some algorithms are used to set these models, and these models enabled softwares are used by the softwares or programs are used by the credit rating agencies to assess the credit of the clients. So in the late 20th century, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, proposed a structured framework based on the financial parameters to model credit risk. See, MIT is a globally very reputed institution. They have proposed a model, a structured framework based on financial parameters to model credit risk. And predicting a default to its 100% accuracy is not possible with any of the credit rating models. That is provided. 100% accuracy is not possible, but information uncertainty is a major constraint in developing a robust credit rating model. So some of the models, I said the models are used, the models are using for determination of credit rating, but these models are not 100% accuracy because, you know, some of the biased information we are taking to insert in the programs. Sometimes this biased information may lead some wrong result, but we can depend on, rely on to up to 90% or 85% accuracy may be there, but it is not possible to have 100% accuracy. It's not possible. I already discussed techniques such as probit and stepwise regression are popular and for many years have been successfully applied to determine credit rates. However, a model based on rank sum test and rank correlation analysis predict the credit rating of a new loan customer with increased accuracy. So CRA models, credit rate or credit score assigned by CRA using credit rating models represent the credit worthiness of a company rated. To process debt, financial institutions such as banks are dependent on predictions related to credit rating. This dependency made determination of credit rates a critical concern. Acquiring credit rates from international agency does not add considerable value to credit worthiness of a company. Some companies believe that if they get ratings from Standard & Poor or some other reputed credit rating agency, that will be an added addition, but it is not something like that. Getting a credit rating from an international agency that does not add considerable value to credit worthiness. Because all companies are similar, But there is a bias on the field of investors as well. If the credit rating by the Standard & Poor's is important rather than as compared to the other companies, there is nothing like that. So the credit rating agencies are all similar. They are using different criteria. But in fact, there was a bias which was adopted by the investors if the rating by the Standard & Poor's or Moody's, which is important. And there are no significant evidence to prove the advantages of acquiring credit rates from international CRAs over domestic agencies. So recent studies says that there is no significant evidence to prove the advantage of acquiring credit rates from international CRAs over domestic agencies. So conclusion, identification of need to develop a hybrid credit rating mechanism by integrating different methods such as machine learning techniques, regression, super vector machines, etc. So researchers and lenders in this domain shall explore the development of credit rating by considering the views proposed in this review. So credit rating models based on these advanced tools and techniques will only sustain in future. So there is a hybrid model should be developed to be like a role model criteria to the all credit rating agencies. That is not so far developed. So the companies can develop a hybrid model which include all the qualitative and quantitative criteria. But in fact, 60 to 70% we can depend on the credit rating, rely on the credit rating by the credit rating agencies. Okay. So any questions on this, you can ask.